Hey, good evening, everyone. It's the October 26th meeting of the Board of Sewer Commissioners. To call the meeting to order. Myself, Jim Gibberdy, present.
Malcolm White, present.
Donna Bronk, present.
Okay. And we'll go into the approval of the minutes from the October 12th meeting. Everybody's.
Yeah, I saw these. Make a motion that we accept the minutes as.
Presented.
Yeah, I'll second that.
All in favor?
Aye.
Three, zip, zip. Okay. Citizens' participation. Oops, who we got? Who's here?
That was quick.
Oh, yeah. We didn't want anybody to fall asleep out there.
Quick. My name's Joe Mulkern, and I live in Wychunas Avenue in the Buzzards Bay area there. And I was curious about, a couple of months ago, the sewer department came down there. I saw two of the men going on the dirt road there, and I asked what they were doing. And they were saying they're checking the pipes there. And back a few years ago, when I was doing some work on the beach there, I dug up a piece of pipe there in the street, and it looked like years ago someone might have was diverting a septic system or something like that, and they really never did anything other than smash it up. And I was just curious what the sewer department's doing with the piping. Are they just surveying it or something? They mark things off.
Guy, can you address that?
I can try. Down in the Wychunas area along the beach by the Saltworks pump station, we're doing an I&I study. It's being conducted by Bader Engineering, and we've been helping out. We've cambered that line along the beach. We've inspected the manholes, and now we're on the other side of the Saltworks pump station doing the same. We've been doing this throughout the town. We've been in the marshlands looking at manholes and pipes for infiltration. Yeah, it's part of that infiltration study.
Yeah, so.
So in other words, the sewer line is on the dirt road. It's not on the beach.
It's actually the edge of the dirt road is where the sewer line is.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Absolutely. It's right there on the edge, and there's manholes.
There's always people doing things up there, digging around, and you know, when I'm starting to dig up this, I know the pipe must be down fairly low. So, in fact, when I moved there, I know the house I bought there, within a year's time there, my sewer line clogged up. I don't know why, and I had to hire a contractor. And when they put my porch on there before I lived there, they drove right through the pipe, and I'm surprised that the people got the sewage out of it. But it's a big pipe, 6 inches.
Six inches.
So I learned.
Probably the horseshoe crabs.
6 inches.
So then that's all they wanted to ask. Okay. And I just wanted to see how you people operated, because I'm glad to see your separate entity from the selectman's office, because I used to go to all the meetings and watch you in particular dealing with the selectman all the time, and I appreciate what you people are doing. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thanks for coming. Next victim.
Well, you're actually on the agenda, so I would probably wait. I think you're on the agenda.
No, they're not. I don't.
Okay, I'm sorry. I thought you were on the agenda.
You didn't put it down, huh?
Rebecca
says they're there.
New business,
yeah.
So it's up to you. I mean,
oh, that's
Elm
Street.
Elm Street, yeah.
Because I think on participation, nothing can be done, so I would wait for the.
Okay, misread that. My mistake.
No problem.
Sorry. Misread that. Okay, that's that. Sewer business, we have an abatement. That. And you're recommending a denial. Is there? I mean, according to the reasoning that's here, I wonder why the denial, aside from a date.
8 days.
There's a couple of reasons. One is that they didn't meet the deadline. On the back of the bill, it gives you so many days to apply.
Yeah.
If you miss the application date, then you have to wait till the next cycle. Second reason why, she bought a piece of property, and she's contending the sewer bill between the old owner and the new owner. And that should be handled at the closing through the, on the HUD statement. And so there's no provision in our policies to address, you know, telling her she can go after the owner or making the owner pay their part, the former owner pay their part. It's really something that we don't get involved in. So the denial is based upon, in this particular, specifically not meeting the deadline, but there's underlying things that would still require denial.
But you're basically just denying it on the 8 days.
Yeah, I think it's a little more than that, but it's, I think it's so many days after the final due date of the bill. If I remember the policy, I apologize, but yeah, it's so many days after. So you get a bill, you got 30 days to pay it, and then after that, the time starts clicking, so for you to apply for the abatement, and they didn't meet that criteria. As it says, the filing deadline was the 12th, they did it the 20th, so just to meet the dates. But if you read her complaint.
8 days, yeah.
She got some bad information.
Yes.
Yeah.
If you read this, it's just, no, there's no way that we do this, so it's just.
Well, we don't
chase previous owners.
I make a motion, Mr. Chairman, that we deny it as recommended by the superintendent. For reasons given.
Yeah, we don't have any choice. I'll second that.
Yeah.
Okay, y'all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. 3-0. Okay. Somebody have the stopwatch. Superintendent's report, please.
Again, I'll be very brief. I know, in spirit of those who appreciate brevity, I'll just be very brief. We had sent out letters requesting those that have grinder pumps to submit their maintenance agreements. We don't have any. And what I want to discuss specifically is that we have two policies, one under residential, one under commercial. And in both of them, the criteria is not only get a maintenance contract annually and sent to the sewer department, the second leg is that it must be registered to registered deeds with that property. So it'll be with the property for the rest of his life, stating that there's a grinder pump that requires maintenance. That hasn't been done, so we're trying to research that. And so at a later date, I will take the policy. It was written a while ago, and they dealt with mostly 1,500-gallon tanks or 1,000-gallon tanks. And today, there's a lot of E1 pumps and a whole different criteria, so we should rewrite some of the criteria. But we should always maintain that maintenance agreements have to be there, because if the pump system fails and you have a pressure main coming by you, there's a potential that the sewer passing you could go into your building. And so you're obligated to maintain your pump station to make sure the check valves are right, the pumps are right, and all this good stuff. And then you have a hire company to come in, and it's been averaging probably $500 a visit. Sometimes you need three, sometimes you need four, sometimes you need one, sometimes you need two, depending on the actual rig. But that's what I wanted to discuss. So there's letters out there requesting this, and I believe there's like 89 of them throughout town. We're trying to, you know, get a handle on them. So the board, I've got copies of what I sent out. For the board's pleasure, but yes, I will revise these, bring them to the board for, you know, discussion and how we should go forward on this particular problem with grinder pumps.
One second, Guy.
Yeah, absolutely.
You still have some more to finish, right?
No, I'm pretty done. I mean, I figured boards from the question from the boards, we can really get into some specifics.
Okay, because I was going to say, I think that we should take people in the audience, and I think we should take the people that are in the audience that are waiting to be heard.
Oh, absolutely.
and not make them wait for,
but they're having such a grand time out there watching us.
I
mean, you think they want to leave this?
Yes, I do think they do want to leave.
I appreciate that. That's,
they would probably want to like to get home for dinner.
We can discuss this over.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Where we can discuss it more.
Yeah.
And I'd like to move on to the, if it would be all right with you.
That's
fine.
That's not a problem.
Okay.
But I thought they was just here for the entertainment value.
Huh?
I wouldn't disagree with you.
Okay.
Thank you. Good call. Good point.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
You're entirely welcome, madam. Thank you for coming tonight. Okay.
Came out of my sick bed for you.
Okay, why don't we hop down to new business.
Okay.
And do the Elm Street scenes there. Sitting there chomping at the bit to get up here and
okay.
do something. It's nice you could bring him out tonight.
Every once in a while I let him out.
Is this the night the home lets him out?
Sure.
Okay.
I got my worst fear, right?
Everything's good.
Thank you. Mr. Gilberti, if you would please, my wife and I would like to speak in tandem, if at all possible.
I don't hear in stereo.
Thank you, pardon?
I can't hear in stereo.
Oh, yeah. We'll talk one at a time.
Okay.
Oh!
The reason we're here today is to... The reason we're here today is to see how we can, put in a shut-off valve on our...
Cabin.
We want to cap our sewer. We have, it is, you do not have to dig anything. There is a manhole cover. You lift it up, the pipe is there. We have had many problems, and we have worked on them for 2 years at this time. And we have a judgment from the judge in Superior Court that the sewer belongs to us. No one else should be using it. And we want to make sure that we are the only ones. We have been paying all of the expenses. No one has contributed anything to it. So now that we have the judgment, I would like to cap the sewer.
Mr. Chairman,
yes,
if
please,
I may,
if you will.
If she has a court judgment, it's on private property. We have nothing to do with it. I feel we shouldn't endorse it. We shouldn't discuss it. It's her decision from the court. She can take a court order and do what she pleases. I don't think it's something that we need to get involved in.
Yeah, on the basis of you having a court order, I don't see where we would come into it. I mean, I understand we've been involved because of the way things have been thus far, but if you've got a court order judgment that it's yours, it's on your property, it's nobody's supposed to use it. I don't think there's anything for us to do.
Well, I just want to make sure that...
Is someone else using it now?
Yes.
The diner.
The diner. It's tied to the diner. The diner
has been using it. They will not contribute towards any maintenance or any care. We have paid over $30,000 just with this, and they just assume that they should be able to use it for free.
Court found otherwise.
But the court, I have a copy of the judgment if you want to see that.
I would get a copy to our attorney.
Yeah.
But my point is, I think with your judgment and you owning the station, there's nothing we can do, nothing to get
what
involved.
What I would suggest at this point is you give us a copy of the judgment, we'll get it to the attorney, our attorney, and see whether there's anything that we don't recognize at the moment that needs to be done. I mean, as far as I can see, it's pretty cut and dried.
Have you notified the diner?
We have every month.
Multiple times.
Every month we keep giving them...
Certified letters, lawyers' letters. And the bills keep mounting and mounting. It's not gonna pass.
Are you going there for breakfast?
No, thank you. So I can give you this copy of the judgment.
If you would, please, and I will bring it to the lawyer tomorrow. Oh, well, yeah, I'll try to get it to him tomorrow. If he's no, he won't be tomorrow. I'll do it on Monday because he won't be there tomorrow.
What I'll do is I'll scan it when I get back to the plant, get him an electronic copy, and then we can get him a hard copy.
Yeah, and send me a copy.
I'll scan it in. Yep. But I think our attorney should be the one that decides.
Well, actually, in this instance, yeah, because we're dealing with a court judgment.
That's right.
And according from what you're telling me and what's there without reading it, assuming that everything's on the same page.
It's very clear.
You know, from my feeling is that, you know,
I just assumed the attorney took care of it myself, too.
But I just assume, from our benefit, I think we just need to have him just review it and see if there's anything that we're missing in this conversation. I don't believe so, but...
The town lawyer.
You're going to give it to the town lawyer to review?
Yes, that's all. All I want him to do is to tell us we're doing the right thing by staying out of it.
I've dealt with him and you about this whole sewer situation. And to say the least, I'm very disappointed in both your behaviors. So, sir, with that in mind, he has no reason to look at it because we have a judge's decision. What's he going to do, overrule the judge?
No, John, John.
I don't want him in.
No, he's not going to overrule the judge at all. Bottom line is the judge's order.
The bottom line is he's our legal counsel, not yours. As our legal counsel, I want him to advise us that we're doing the correct thing. Has nothing to do, it has nothing to do with how you feel about it. It has to do with whether we're doing it correctly.
Okay, I'm not waiting 9 months. I want to cap that tomorrow morning.
John.
Isn't going to happen. Well, I don't say this isn't going to happen. You can do what you want.
It's your property.
Yeah. But if it's something wrong, then that's another game.
That's between you and the legal. That's nothing. I don't believe it has anything to do with us.
I'm not trying to hold you up. I'm not trying to delay anything. Unfortunately, today is Thursday.
Yes.
Town hall is closed on Friday. So it's Friday, Saturday, Sunday. There's nobody there. I can't see him or do anything with him until Monday, the earliest.
Okay.
And all I want him to do is just tell us that we're making the right decision in telling you to go ahead because it's not in our...
It's not in our purview.
That's it.
That's why we're here.
I don't think it's in our purview either, but yeah. I would not want to say one thing or the other because I don't want to get into legal problem because I know once you do that, there's going to be a huge problem. You know it too.
We
okay?
know it too.
Okay, but we just want to stay out of it.
Yes, but it's been
a while.
It's 5 weeks that Mr. Zidi has received this statement, and he still says he doesn't have to pay. So I'm done.
Yeah, and Mr. Chairman, when I discussed this with our attorney previous to this meeting, he suggests we listen to what they had to say, take no action, and go from there, because the question became as who has responsibility. It is private property.
Right.
And so
exactly.
It was wise to listen. We have listened. We'll vet we'll have the attorney vet the judgment, but I still believe it's going to be nothing to do with us. They can do what they choose to do.
I don't disagree with that. The only thing I want to do is make sure that we're... Yeah.
I understand.
Not
you have to protect
ourselves.
Yourself.
Oh, that's all.
But I'm requesting that this is done
expeditiously.
Hopefully, yes. It'll be done, before the end of the week. And I don't talk about this next week because I can't do anything till Monday.
So I would have to come back next Thursday to hear.
I think the next meeting is the 9th.
Well, actually, as far as I'm concerned, we'll give you a call.
Will give me a call.
I will.
Chairman or myself, yeah. Whatever. Mr. Chairman, we'll get back to the best
No, I mean, I've been through this.
Yeah. No, I'll give you a call.
Okay.
Next week. A day. I can't tell you what day right now. It depends what day I get to see him. Or what he gives me.
Well,
all I need is your phone number.
I asked you to give us a call the last time. Instead,
I had the lawyer.
Privately in executive session. You had a meeting with all the town boards.
Yeah, that's correct.
And Mr. Campana, and you never called us once. So
no, I did not.
No.
I realize that.
Would you
and
please
I
tell me
regret.
Why the chairman of a board?
Well, I didn't call you.
You lied, sir.
Well, you can call it what you want. I don't believe that's the case. I didn't call you because the lawyer said he was going to get in touch with you.
Yeah, well.
That was why.
Now,
you can pick it up and run any kind of words you want, but that doesn't mean I'm going to take and go along with you.
No, it's fine.
You're fine.
I have
get the muzzle for him.
I have been through this already.
Yep. No, I understand.
Okay. I had to come to the selectmen's meeting on Tuesdays to catch the lawyer because he would not call me. I had to come here and Shanghai him. So I'm asking, I would like a
phone
call.
I'll give you a phone call. Not a problem.
Yeah.
Thank you.
It's not only you, he doesn't call back.
Well, I understand that.
Okay.
I do. It took me a little while, but I do understand.
Okay.
Shall I give you? Do you have a piece? Oh, here. I'll put it right here. No, I got a pen. I just want to give it.
Piece of paper?
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Mrs. Assad.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Assad.
And we have some other victims?
Yeah.
Yes, we have requests for assisted living tying into the sewer system.
Is this like God's waiting room?
I'm sorry. You have a copy, Mr. Chairman.
Yes.
Numbers of the letter requesting 14,080 gallons per day and to connect in that to the Linwood Ave area, to the manhole in the upper part of Linwood Ave.
You're on.
Okay, good evening. For the record, John Churchill, JC Engineering. I'm representing Fred Mannix, who's with me here tonight. This is a project off of Sandwich Road, about 238-240 Sandwich Road. It's two buildings, assisted living facility. As you can see, it's the magenta outline on the plan.
John, excuse me.
Sure.
Where exactly is that located?
Right, essentially, you see Route 28, actually to the, I guess, to the east. It's right, almost right next to the Upper Cape Realty office at the corner of Cranberry Highway.
Gotcha, okay. Gotcha, okay, I know what you mean. Yep, yep, okay, I know, right next to the boatyard.
To the old Tucci.
Yeah, okay.
It's on the right-hand side, basically coming down, and it's wooded and is an old structure.
Yep.
And it's basically what we are is we're about, as you can see, a little over about 1,100 feet from Linwood, where there's a sewer manhole. So what we're looking doing is hopefully get approval for the 14,080 gallons. So we construct these buildings, put a pump station and a force line in to connect to the sewer manhole over in Linwood in order to do the project.
Okay, now that's something that you will be putting in at your cost?
Yes, Mr. Chairman, okay. That's right.
Guy, is there any objection to this? We've got the capacity.
We have the 14,000 gallons of capacity, Mr. Chairman. There's some conditions. There'll be feasibility study.
Right.
Be impact studies to the line and to the pump station. And of course, they got to get state approval to put a force main. So they've got the work cut off for them. But as far as we're concerned, I don't see any reason why should be denied.
The only question I have with this proposal says a drawdown test will be made on the existing pump station to determine the pumping rate. An upgrade of the existing pump station may be necessary, you know, contingent upon the results. Now
that's the impact. That's
your nickel, okay.
That's all they get to their responsibility is
no problem.
Their impact, they will rectify the impact.
Okay.
It's all on.
Okay, just double checking.
And in the calculations, we are gonna take into consideration all the property owners along the line as well. So when we do the calculations, we're gonna make sure that if those owners do wanna tie in, or you can tie in, that they don't have to upgrade the line, basically. So the sewer pump station will be able to accommodate that run of neighbors as well. They're across from the Cranberry Bog. A lot of those homes are across from the Cranberry Bog.
Right.
So that we are gonna take that into the design calculations.
Okay.
I make a motion that we approve the project to go forward as stated legally and
do I have a second?
I'll second it.
All right, all in
favor?
As long
as we have the capacity.
Yep.
Yes, I agree. The capacity's there. What we're granting is the ability to use that capacity and the conditions, which will come later.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
300.
Thank you very much.
That didn't even hurt.
That didn't.
How's your reserve doing, Guy, on capacity?
Well, that's a good question. We're meeting tomorrow. We're revising it. We're looking at it. We've done some INR removal. We had the original study back in 2011 done by Woodward and Kern, which said we had 156,000 gallons per day available. And so we've been deducting from that. So giving basic math, we're around 35,000 gallons per day. That being said, there's some other factors. Contract fee was never completed. Mm-hmm. So that's added back into the formula. And remember, for our buffer, everything is done by Title V calculations. Mm-hmm. When you take Title V calculations and the actual calculations of sewer flow, there's a discrepancy, anywhere from 20 to 40%. So that's a good buffer for us. So
yep.
We have the capacity.
Okay. Business manager. We've had, I think it's... time with everything going on that we need to.
Are we tying up Selectman Tropiano?
Yes.
Are we tying you up? You wanna, should we tying him up? Is
nope.
He here for
no,
the
he's,
bond?
He's looking.
Oh, okay, I didn't know if you were looking.
No, no,
oh,
no.
Oh, okay.
You know, technically I'm your liaison, I should show up once in a
while. I was thinking that.
Ask me, I'll come anytime.
Oh, okay, okay.
I thought it might be nice
to
show up for that.
Okay. All right. Sorry, Mr. Chairman.
That's okay.
If there's any questions I can answer, I'd be happy to.
Well, may have.
Is this something you've been working on, Jimmy? Or?
Yes.
Okay. I'm listening.
I mean, I think it's, you know, with all that Guy is doing and the amount of work that's piled on him and the different directions, we've got some major things online for the plant, primarily the outfall, which you'd like to get pushed. We've got Grisilla, we've got a lot of things plant-wise. We've got an issue.
Is the Grisilla working yet?
Yes, it just back online. It was off the line for a month. We burnt out some internal parts, regular maintenance, so it's back online. Yes, it's working.
And it just seems that, you know, with the discussion that's going on with Bourne at the moment, they seem to have concerns about billing procedures and all, that it's maybe about time we get a business manager to handle that stuff and take that kind of a load off of Guy's back. So he can concentrate on the plant itself. And
I'd rather
and
see him concentrate on the plant and
yeah.
All the field operations myself.
Yeah.
Me too.
Absolutely. I remember when I took this position, I asked the town administrator at the time, Derek Sullivan was leaving, and I said, could I have him as an accountant business manager? Because with an $8 million enterprise, you need an accountant. When I had the audit, the board has concerns. One of the recommendations is that we get an accountant at the plant to work with the accountant. The accountant at the plant would be an enterprise-geared accountant, and work with the town municipal accountant. And they said it's at the size of the plant and what's going on, it's almost imperative that we do that. So we've been asking for 4 years, 7 years now, we've been asking, and so I think it's a great idea. I think it's something we should move forward. It's encouraged, and I'm actually working right now with the Human Resource Director to develop a job description, to
right,
develop.
I was gonna ask.
Yeah, we're developing that. We're pooling all the different communities that have business managers, that have business accountants for this type of enterprise system, and we're pooling all that, getting their information. She's actually able to go to the MIA, different websites, and as Human Resource Officer, she has her own contacts. We're trying to pull this all together and write up the best description that would meet the needs of the plant and going forward. Absolutely. I've discussed with Mr. Sullivan. I've given him some ideas, even some of his ideas. So this has been going on for years because it is important. It really is. I mean, there's a lot going on, especially the IMA. That's the job of the town accountant. The IMA is that responsibility. It's the responsibility of the town administrator, and that's never happened. And I think when the accountant down there, that gets to be taken care of. It's and they meet regularly.
I looked
regularly.
At some of the questions.
Yeah. So I think it's important.
On the IMA.
I think it's very important, and I'm really happy that we're moving in that direction to get this type of thing taken care of.
I agree.
Well, I think
the size of the budget, it's not hard to justify the need.
Right.
Not at all. We need
you've got more stuff going on now.
Absolutely,
so
absolutely.
Just a lot of it's mandated, and you get
right.
The outfall, the INI, the repairs, SR funding we got to go after. So an accounting on site that can do grants and all that, and absolutely, it's imperative. It's imperative.
Besides the junk we throw at you,
well,
so I
that's part of the game.
Do I have the
I'm making a motion
feeling that everybody's in favor of this?
Yes.
Yeah, I'd like to pursue it.
Okay.
I would too.
That's, Cheryl.
Make a motion.
I don't think we, you don't need a motion on this.
And then the job description?
Yeah, I'd like to see that.
This person has to be available to us.
Yes, definitely.
At a meeting, when needed.
Absolutely. Part of their job description is to be available for meetings.
I might learn something.
Another part is the ad hoc. Anytime that the board asks for information, they will make sure it's supplied to the board. That's all part of the job description. I can show you as we're writing it, but it's very critical, absolutely, even though this is day to day.
I think we'd all like to see the job description prior to.
Yeah, we'd like to see the, yeah.
See, you understand this better than I do, so.
Yeah, you understand the physical plan.
Yeah.
Because it's in the hands of the human resource director, because between her and Mr. Sullivan, day to day operations and hiring comes directly under their purview.
Mm-hmm.
But reviewing it, absolutely, we'll definitely review with the board everything that's being done, so they're aware. But that's day to day, and that's Mr. Sullivan and Miss, I think it's England, Doreen, I, please, I mean, being formal, but I call him most by Doreen, but.
Yeah, and it would be nice to have him available to us at least once a month.
Absolutely. Absolutely, especially during budget season, anytime we apply for funding. I mean, we're looking at major liabilities for our infrastructure, and we need to borrow money, and it's gonna be budgeted. And when we get the CIP budget from the CPA back to us, that needs to be incorporated, so this person can really help incorporate that.
Right.
New rate setting. Rate setting is critical, and one of the job criteria is gonna be able to work with rate setting and billing and all that.
Every time we make a decision, we need to know all the contributing factors.
Absolutely.
I'm not saying anybody's perfect.
No.
No.
And nobody can do it all.
But if this person, he or she is doing that,
that'll be helpful.
The plan will run better if you're doing that.
Absolutely. I remember talking to the chairman of the finance committee, Mr. Heath, who I really have a lot of respect for, years ago, and he said in his line of work, he can look at numbers and tell the condition of anything. And he proved it out. So numbers are critical. So to have an accountant, you know, that has a degree in accounting, a degree in, that person has been trained and have with experience, you're golden, because it's the heartbeat. It's the heartbeat. So I think this is a dynamite idea. I've been pushing for this for years. I think other members have been. I think it's time. I really do. I'm excited.
I don't want to just see an accountant. I want to see somebody.
Business manager. Well, remember, a CPA with business, it's the whole, it's a combination of if you will, combination of disciplines. Absolutely. There's somebody that has to know numbers. They can't just be
they'll need to,
a
but they'll
bookkeeper,
need to,
a company.
They have to know how to run the business.
It's run through. The business is run through numbers. It's a numbers game. I don't know of any business that doesn't rely on a CFO. If you don't have a CFO, you just really don't have a business. And this person will be that type. And as you say, because we have an administrative business office, their responsibility would be to make sure the office runs, that every person is getting the right data, the data is being entered, absolutely. And it's just running this, absolutely. And I think it's part of it. It's important. It's important.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes, ma'am.
We have.
Yes, I'm sorry.
I want you to know that the Board of Selectmen had some conversation with this. I think we did with you, Jim.
Yeah, and me.
And we totally agree that this is something that needs to be done. It will take a lot of the burden off a guy for some of the other things that he has to do, and help with a lot of the things that need to come across to the town side. So we're totally in favor of it. Just so you know.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's good to know.
I was at that meeting.
Yeah.
I think it's a long time coming too, and I do approve. And do we have to take a vote, or do we?
I don't. No, we can make a motion and take a vote on it. I don't think it's necessary, but it'll be on the record anyhow.
Do we?
Anyhow.
Motion to support.
Yeah.
Motion. Yeah. I make a motion to support the hiring of a business manager.
Yep. I'll gladly second that.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Good.
Thank you.
Okay. Everybody's received a copy in their folder on a list for the IMA.
Mm-hmm.
This is some of the stuff.
That's just touching the surface. Yes, that's some of the
stuff.
Could help us, the selectmen.
I'm sorry?
The town. It could help us, the selectmen, in our town administrator, manager.
I think with this,
This is the stuff.
We're talking about the IMA right now.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, so it's just...
This is some of the stuff.
Absolutely.
What I'd like to do is to go over this and the ones that aren't here.
There was a lot more.
There was a lot more, and I don't know where it is, so we were supposed to get it. Well, I wanted to get this thing before this meeting, so we'd have a chance to go over it, so we could discuss it.
This is your heading, some of this, and then we could just subdivide this. For example, the inclusion of debt service, that's something we need to discuss. So I think what you're talking about, Madam Bronk, is revenues. In the IMA, it says that Bourne credits us $10,000 or 200 ton of free disposal, and we didn't start getting that to 2011. They ignored the IMA since 1998. We've paid, and I've got records, we've paid thousands and thousands,
mm-hmm,
plus
exactly.
$300,000 in
a guy,
disposal.
All of this stuff that you're verbalizing.
Details.
Excuse me. Mm-hmm. All of this stuff that you're verbalizing right now, I'd like to see it on a piece of paper
so we'll be on the same page. You and I, and put that back together because the attorney evidently doesn't recall the list and everything, because I know we had a detailed list of everything. Well, not of everything, but lots of things that we weren't collecting money for, affecting us, and we weren't even sure if they were doing what they were supposed to do on their end, so.
It's like a meter. They meter their flow to
the
us.
Meters, exactly.
It's never been calibrated.
Yep.
We don't have any rights to that meter. They supply numbers that we don't even know if they're close to being true because that meter's never been calibrated. Mm-hmm. And so we've asked for calibration. And the IMA says they will calibrate it annually. They'll supply us with the numbers that we have a right to be there. That's never happened. So how do I know those numbers are true? So we're building on their numbers, and we have to trust that those numbers are correct. So those are a lot of the issues sub to this stuff. That's below the surface. So I think it's... That's funny. You should open the door. That'd probably blow his mind. He's probably here looking. That's funny.
That happened to me when I was in a parking lot. I pulled up, it was just getting out of my car, and all of a sudden the car next to me, it had a dog in it.
Oh, that's funny.
It started up, and I'm going,
I did. I spent a lot of time on this with
We just started your car for you. We just started it for you.
I pushed the button here to see if the thing would make noise while you were up there looking.
That's funny stuff. Wow.
I'd like to suggest that we get more information to this so that we can review it and come up with our own list of things that should be added.
If Guy can make some time for me, I'll
absolutely.
I'll
just tell me when you're coming down and sit down.
And
we'll dive
all
through all this stuff. There's tons of stuff here. And I gotta be very nervous because sometimes I give her information and never get it back, so I have to learn to photocopy everything. Like the original document from the town of Bourne talking about the 2 cents, and we had to add 2 cents, 11 mm-hmm. cents. I think one of the haulers made it an issue, and I had to go chase the document for the second time. And Bourne was like, we gave it to you. And so, well, I turned it into the selectman's office, so sewer commission time at that office, not the individuals. It was sent to the office in general, and nobody could find it. So it's kind of embarrassing not to have the document. So I'm trying, forgive me, but I'm being very protective of the original document. So I'll try to photocopy. When we meet, we'll photocopy everything.
Trust me, I know. We'll make sure Rebecca's there too.
Yeah, because and we're supposed to, years have been collecting 11 cents because we give them back 2 cents to make it 9 cents. That never happened. So technically, when we give them the 2 cents a gallon, people in Bourne are paying less than the people in Wareham.
Exactly,
subsidizing there. So those are the things that there's financial implications that we need to discuss. I mean, so there's a lot of issues, both sides.
Exactly.
There's a lot of issues.
And this time we're going to put the selectman on, put Selectman Trapiano on copy too.
And I have original copies from 2010, 29, that express the same concerns.
Okay, yep.
So these concerns have been going on for the past, you know, 5, 6, 7, 8 years and beyond. So I think it's time that the board sit down, and I'll be very blunt. We should work as a team because Bourne and Wareham has a partnership, whether it's 20%, 80%, and we need to sit down and figure where do we go? What's best for everybody?
We have
how
to
do we make
dialogue.
This relationship work? forget the, you know, and I don't like bygones be bygones, but if we keep dredging up and peeling the scab back and still say you did this, you did that, we'll never get anywhere. Reasonable minds have to really take over, and we have to make some agreements going forward that everybody can live with and follow through. Every 2 years they're meeting, every 5 years, and in between, I mean, meetings have to be consistent, attended, debates have to happen, and so they don't get blown out of proportion, you deal them right away.
Well, communication should be better.
Absolutely, that's what has to happen to make it work in the long term. Because to be very blunt, if we're going to do this plant expansion, move the outfall, community relationships, this has to be an ongoing communication, understanding thing. So it's just the beginning of a long-term thing. So I think it's important that we sit down and air all this stuff out and come to some agreements and move forward. I really believe that. But nonetheless, that's... So anytime you come down willing, we'll go through this. We'll put a packet together, what you feel, we'll copy everything, and then we'll scan it to in and to all the board members, and then we can you can have everything.
We'll set up a date
that you can
make time, because I know you're busy, and I mean, my schedule's pretty flexible. I can get away. Cool. I just been waiting for Rebecca to come back from vacation and that too.
Yes, you just got back, so we'll, and I'll talk to Rebecca Monday morning, and we'll get it. We'll pick a date, and we'll call you and give you the different options, and we'll set it up.
Oh, I know she's here, so it's good then.
Yeah.
Women can handle so many things at one time.
I don't.
You're better at multitasking.
Multitasking.
I knock them down one at a time. Sorry, it's the way I am.
There's nothing wrong with that either.
That's okay. That's fine. That's fine.
In sequence, though, that could be the difference. I do it in sequence.
Oh, I bet you eat your mashed potatoes and you go around a plate like that, too, huh? You don't mix them together.
A place for everything, and everything has a place. Okay. So if with your blessing, Mr. Chairman, I'll wrap up my report. We'll go back to it real briefly.
Please
unless
do.
I think you've done everything on the new
sure.
business.
Yep.
Well, I'll go back and just wrap it up. So, I, again, on that, what I would like to do is I'll take the policy. There's a commercial and a residential. The difference usually is duplex pumping, single pumping, and it was all geared towards the bigger tanks. We have some on Main Ave coming out of the Springbourne. I think we have four or five. We always thought we had just one, other than the school. And then we've got the Smithers tied into it. Then along just before the intersection of, I think it's Hathaway, there's a couple more houses. I just discovered this. So we need to really update everything and make sure they get their agreements in place and get them to us on an annual basis regularly, and that they're registered at the record of the registry deeds. Because if you buy that house, you need to know your obligations. If the seller fails to tell you, you have a problem. And on the deed, it's there. And the title search, it's there, so it's not a mystery. Mm-hmm. I think we really need to enforce that. So I'll play with the policy, give you the original. You have the original, it's in your packet, and I'll play with it, give you an original and a copy we're playing with. We can sit down and we can figure out the best way to approach it, what we're gonna keep and what we're not gonna keep, and we can make it fit today's, you know, more true to today opposed to 1998 and 1996. So that's all I want to say about that. So we have letters. I got letters out to all the owners, mm-hmm. and commercial and residential, asking for this documents. And then at least we'll get that part going. We'll have the maintenance agreements. We'll know where everybody is. And then we can talk about the policy in its existence that they're supposed to record the registry deeds. I'll have Rebecca do some research and see if, in fact, that's ever happened on any of them. And then I'll report back to the board on that. Then we can move forward. And that's okay. Now let me just see what else there was. I think the bid openings were Tuesday. Funny story. Well, it's not funny. I had the night before, I think town meeting, I was in town meeting, and I was feeling awfully chilly, and my stomach was crampy. And anyways, I got home and I ate something that my body said shouldn't have ate that. Mm-hmm. So the next day I had a bid opening. I called in sick, and all of a sudden I get an email. And I forgot totally. You got a bid opening. Okay. So anyways, we did the bid opening, and I had read the numbers. I wasn't feeling well, and so I said 115, 111, 136, and so we said, okay, and it's unofficial, just so for your edification, when we do bid openings, everything's unofficial till we actually vet to make sure they responded properly. Mm-hmm. The bonds are in place, and you know, everything is as required. So we then so the person walked away. So the company that had the winning bid by numbers was, okay, yeah, that's great, and everybody else left. When we reread the documents and we got a call from one of the bidders, said, do you need to read that again? Well, $99,480 won the bid, which is substantially less than we thought. So it really worked out well. So so we're getting three generators replaced. We're getting, it's Thatcher, Salt Works, and let me see if I have it, and one other. But anyways, three are getting replaced. We've been doing this annually. We have three more that are outdated, and then we're all done with the current outdated generators, so that would be 12 that we've done, and then we'll reevaluate the ones that we just kind of said were within the numbers. And we'll reevaluate those and put those on a schedule, maybe starting 3 years from now, whatever the case may be. But the generators are mandated by the EPA, so we really need to know that they work when we call. When we want them on, we have to have them on. So that's where we are with that. I have the actual bid results, so I forgive me. I want to make sure I'm not misrepresenting anything.
Do you have a copy of the updated policy that we passed last?
It's in here for you to sign.
Oh, okay.
It's in the signature, because you guys have proved it, now you need to sign it. So it's in here. At the end of the meeting, we'll sign it. That's the updated policy. You'll put it into effect with your signature. That's all set. That's all set. You're good. I thought I had a folder of...
It's on the left corner of your desk.
No, I know. I got one right there. I'm going to go. Maybe I threw it back in that big pile, but... I definitely had the, I definitely had it. I just, it's with her stuff.
You've got it anyhow.
I have
so.
It. I have it, so I will make sure. But that's the one on the generator. So I wanted to let the board know that that's pretty, it's working. It's working. And, you know, last year we had two bidders. One was disqualified. This year I think we had six or seven. Really good for us. The more people that come out and bid on these projects, the better it's for us. We seem to get a better deal because the numbers came down. When we started this years ago, we were getting good numbers because we had plenty of bidders. And then the last couple of years, nobody was bidding. Mm-hmm. And so it seemed the numbers are creeping up. And all of a sudden, we had seven bidders, and the numbers are back down. So it's encouraging. It's really, really encouraging. So I'm pleased with the whole thing.
Good.
So, and that's pretty much my report, but I was just double checking.
I looked at your permit plans.
I'm sorry?
I looked at your plans for those pump stations.
Yes, and we'll keep sending. We'll keep sending. It's going to be, I mean, the whole resiliency thing is really incredible, and those three pump stations, especially Narrows, it's an incredible, important pump station. And
good plan. You can reuse what's there.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
That's a good plan.
It really is. So we'll keep updating. We're still doing some. I also sent to Mr. Bowen today the contract forms, because it has to go out to bid, the repairs, because it comes under 149M, and so it has to go out to bid. So we prepared all those documents.
All three?
Yes, and we prepared all the documents. So I got them for review, and then we'll put them back in a packet. And so part of this issue is going to be to put that out the bid and get some real hard numbers. And so when we move forward to start doing the stations, we're going to have real hard numbers. And then we
can
apply for some funding. There's no sense in spending this money and just saying, okay, we're done. We need to follow through. It's an important project. So, and I appreciate the board's support. It's really huge. It means a lot. So I appreciate it. And I think that's all I have. I'm just anal trying to find this piece of paper. I apologize. It's just, there it is. Oh, I had it. I knew I had it. Also, I think we all know about the meeting coming up with the Onset Water District. I think that's all confirmed. So I want everybody to be aware of that. November 8th at 6:30. November 8th at 6:30.
November 8th. And where's that
going to
be?
At the district, Onset Water District.
The Onset?
Yeah.
It's Onset?
It's a Wednesday.
Onset Water.
That's
their
meeting.
Yeah.
I think Salvation Army behind that.
You going?
I got to tell you, it's really a lot of work. I appreciate the efforts there because this is huge. This is huge. We're trying to go.
Yeah, it's just to get an IMA with them.
Yeah.
Work out those details.
Do we have more than two there or not?
It's November 8th.
I believe they're going to do it as a joint meeting.
More than two, you're going to have to post it as a meeting.
Yeah, I would suggest that.
They're posting it that way anyhow, aren't they?
Well, we're not posting it.
No, I said they.
So you can leave it at two.
All right. Who's going?
They have to post it because.
I'll go. Probably Peter will go if he's here.
It's there. One is three.
Unless you want to go.
So they have two.
Okay, I'll better post it somehow. Yeah. Just in case. You better post it now.
November 8th.
Yep.
And it's at 6:30?
Yeah, can you just post that? please.
Yeah, you're right, because then it makes, if you don't go, then it makes you covered.
Maybe I can go too.
Yeah, then you're covered.
Yeah.
You're covered. It makes sense. I agree.
Then we don't have to.
Not a problem.
Nobody has to leave.
Yeah, Mr. Chairman, you're right. Good, good. It's a protection. You don't need it.
We don't have to play musical chairs. One person go in.
Does she have options down there, by the way?
She has, so.
The diner.
The diner has options, but here's the issue.
It's called the pond across the street.
Is they could tie into the two-inch main, but that takes a town meeting vote because they have to have an easement to go through town property. So that kind of happened to spring.
The diner perked a lot today.
Oh, so they're gonna perk.
They're gonna put septic in.
Yeah, then that's their, so there, obviously they have an alternative plan.
The one thing, the only thing I was worried about, and really, it doesn't have anything to do with us at this point, but you create a hardship, and sometimes you open yourself up.
Exactly.
And I agree. The problem is that we don't have, it's private property. We don't have any purview, and I don't want us to make decisions. She's looking for our blessing, and I don't want a blessing that's gonna come back to haunt us.
No.
I can't believe there weren't some conditions about.
And I can't believe that this.
Maybe he is ignoring all the laws.
There was, well, what happened to be, for full disclosure.
Judge just doesn't hand that out and say, shut it off.
The gentleman that made this agreement with the original nail factory, I forget the name, Mazda or Matt, whatever it was, original nail factory, and the gentleman, he's passed away.
Yeah.
And I remember when he got out of the hospital, he called me for a meeting with him, and he just said he was still sick, and I refused to meet with him because I had a cold, and he passed away. But they had agreements in place. There was agreements in place, but you know what? A lot wasn't written down, and if it's not written down, then you don't have an agreement, and that's the problem.
The diner paid
their share of the betterment. They paid the cost. I mean, that's all documented. They were actively involved. They paid money, so it isn't like they weren't involved. But the follow-through was never, ever, you know, put down in writing, and so that's why today it becomes an issue. Because now you have a new owner, right? They split the property. Tom gets a piece. This guy gets a piece. It's his pump station. This guy's tied in. There's a lot of conflict.
But Joe's a pretty savvy businessman.
Council's going to tell you that it's really none of our issue at this point. We've talked about this. The issue was they had an agreement, but the guy who had it before, when the wife took it over, when she was looking at it, they were trying to charge her the whole cost, not just a portion of the cost.
Right.
So she was angry about that, and she wasn't going to pay. And it became a big to-do between the two of them. It ended up in court. They filled the pipe with concrete, if you remember.
I remember that, yep.
A car over the top.
Yep, I remember.
Right. So it ended up in court, and now it's sort of nothing to do with us at this point.
Yep.
Josie bought the place. It's between him and them to decide whether they want to agree to an agreement or not an agreement, or end it, or do whatever. And as far as council is concerned, we're really out of this whole thing. It's up to, you know, and if the court has said to them, well, it's up to him to either appeal it, Joe to appeal it, or just go along with it, or whatever. I mean, that's up to them. It's totally a civil matter in this particular instance. As a matter of fact, you remember, we're still having issues with the electricity, with how it's being powered. And we're dealing with that issue.
That's what we looked at.
But I thought
we
that
couldn't
was
deal with it. Unfortunately, we sent it back to you guys.
Yeah, well, and we are. We're dealing with
it. It was not our jurisdiction.
It's a legal issue now because of what's going on.
Gotta write shit down.
But that's
being dealt with.
Gotta write it
down. But that's being dealt with over the next, 2 years, isn't it?
Yeah.
I think it was.
I'm not so sure. They made an agreement, I forget the time frame, but they agreed to remove their power.
Right.
That's in writing. It's on our
attorney. Yeah, I've seen that. I've seen that particular document.
That's in writing. They agreed. Now, whether they adhere to the agreement, because they agree to a lot of things over the years, I don't know. But there's a written agreement. It's in writing. We made some concessions. They've agreed to them. It's all written, signed by both parties. And so it's been dealt with. Where it goes from here, I don't know.
A very quick-tempered gentleman. Mm. And it makes it difficult to deal with him, to be honest with you.
Arrogant.
Because at one minute he's very nice, and then all of a sudden he just goes off on a tangent.
Right.
So to try to really deal with him is very difficult.
Yeah, I could see that.
She's much more reasonable than he is, but he's very difficult.
And she does a good job recently trying to get
trying to calm him down.
Yes.
Yeah, it's a good thing too. And he although you
I
see
didn't
he
have
was
much
very
to
good,
say,
he was
sitting
on the way out the door.
To say.
He says, "I need a drink."
He should have brought it in with him.
I shut right down.
That's a good thing.
You want to lose me?
Okay, next meeting is November 9th, the 30th, and the 14th of December.
When are you taking us for dinner?
Donna, come on.
I make a motion that we adjourn.
Mr. Chairman, before you go, who's been taking notes? Who's the secretary?
I have.
Okay, good. December 14th, so we got the 9th, the 30th, and 14th of December.
And that'll probably be the only one in December because of the way everything's falling.
Yeah. So here's this to be signed, so after you adjourn, I give it to you, you can sign this, that's your policy.
All in favor for adjournment?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for watching this.
In the future, though.